Yeah. Okay, easy. I ain't gonna hurt you. Okay, then. Yeah, let's try that again. Hey. Settle down. Shh, easy now. Come on. Go easy. Come on now, easy. We're easy now. Go easy. Easy, easy. Easy. Nice and easy. There we go. Go easy. Easy, God damn it! Let's try that again. You're okay. Stay. Hey, wait, where are you going?
You can't turn me in. This ain't just.
No, just. No, wait.
You robbed and murdered your way across half the country.
It's all lies. I ain't never been more than 5 miles from home.
You keep lying, you're gonna make me angry, boy.
Come on now. Yep. Yep.
nice to see you.
Looking like that.
Be a lot easier for you once you're all square.
Thanks for your assistance. Easy now. There we go. okay there. Easy, easy.
Whatever else is in store for us out there, I'll tell you one thing.
What's that?
The rare old pleasure not to be freezing our balls off up in those mountains.
You're not wrong there.
Be well.
And you, Hosea.
Don't tempt me, you repulsive...
Fine, but make sure you get a good price for it. Just make sure it goes into the pot. Not your pop.
Well done, Mr. Morgan. Good job, Arthur. Thank you. Good job, Mr. Morgan.
Mr. Morgan.
You busy, Arthur?
Let's get on.
Good. And you?
Got everything we need.
Good. I think we need another man. Charles?
I'll go get him. Meet us at the wagon when you can.
Sure.
See you, Arthur. Ain't that dumb.
Next time, let the wolves eat all your brain. Then you'll be a genius.
Mr. Morgan, you saved my life, and I'm
Well, I'm very grateful.
Don't mention it, Reverend.
I made a fool of myself.
We've all done it.
I get so confused and angry, and then I hear God laughing at me, and I get even angrier, and, well, I'm a real prize dolt. I know it.
Hey, Arthur. Come here a minute.
What is it?
Can I ask you a favor?
Probably not.
Very funny. Would you do something with Jack? He seems kind of down. All this upheaval can't have been easy on the poor kid.
Why? Because I'm your preferred nursemaid?
Because you do what you say. Please?
Okay. I'll take him in the morning.
Thank you.
What you up to?
Playing.
Anything fun?
I guess.
You want to come fishing with me?
Fishing?
Sure. It's about time that you started to earn your keep.
Okay.
Good. Let's go get your pole then. Now, you do have a fishing pole, don't you?
I sure do. Uncle Jose made me one.
Good. Well, let's go get it then. Go catch us some fish.
Yeah.
I'll mount up and lift you on when you're ready. All right, hold on tight.
So, where are we going?
Just down to the river near here. You shouldn't go too far from camp.
Oh, okay.
You feeling better? I know you was a little sick.
Oh, I'm fine.
You're a brave kid.
So, just like you.
Well, I don't know about brave. I ain't much of a kid no more. Well, your mama might disagree. Her and a few other women, I guess.
What do you mean?
I'm just talking silly. It's been a tough few weeks up in that snow.
I like the snow.
Yes, but not like that.
When are we going back to the other camp?
The one near Blackwater?
Yeah.
Well, we're not. This is our spot. For now, anyway. Why?
I forgot a storybook there. We left so quick.
Well, I'm sure someone can get you another storybook.
Really? When?
Well, we'll see. A fish to catch first. All right, this looks as good a spot as any.
Where should we stand, Uncle Arthur?
Down by the shore. Come on, follow me.
I can't wait to get started. Just by the water there, you mean?
First, we need some bait. I'm gonna use some cheese.
Cheese?
Smellier the better. Now, cast your line. Swing the rod back over your shoulder and bring it forward in a smooth motion. Use your wrist, not your elbow.
Like that?
That's it. Good. All we do now, Jack, is wait for a fish to take the bait.
How do I know when I've got a bite?
Well, if you feel the tip of your fishing rod just twitching, don't yank it yet. That just means one's nibbling. If you feel a hard tug, that's a fish going for the bait, so yank hard to hook it.
You've got a bite, Uncle Arthur?
Fish on the line.
Is it a big one?
You see him fighting there, Jack? That's when you gotta be careful. You'll break the line. Best to wear him out first before you try to reel him in. Now, seems like he's taking a rest now. I'm gonna try reeling him in nice and steady. Look, Jack, it's a bluegill. It's almost as small as you. We should really throw these smaller ones back. Give them a chance to grow up a bit.
Can I take a break from fishing? I want to make something.
Okay.
I'm gonna pick some of those red flowers. I'll be right back.
All right. Let's see what's biting there. Got one, Jack. You gotta stick at things, Jack.
I know.
This one's a smallmouth bass. Not bad.
Fishing sure is boring, Uncle Arthur.
I know. Boring as hell. But then, something happens. And you can get food for days.
Really?
If you're lucky. But until then, you just sit, wait. Try not to worry. It's good for you.
It's good for you?
I guess.
Something's tugging at your rod, Uncle Arthur.
Missed him. That's just a part of fishing, Jack. Whoop, think I got one. What are you making there?
You'll see. It's a surprise. Hey, look at this.
And what?
This necklace I made.
Necklace?
For Mama.
Sure.
What a fine young man. And in such complex circumstances. Arthur, isn't it? Arthur Morgan?
Who are you?
Yes, Arthur Morgan, Vanderlyn's most trusted associate. You've read the files. Typical case, orphaned street kid seduced by that maniac's silver tongue and matures into a degenerate murderer. Agent Milton, Agent Ross, Pinkerton Detective Agency, seconded to the United States government. Nice to finally meet. We know a lot about you.
Do you?
You're a wanted man, Mr. Morgan. There's $5,000 for your head alone.
$5,000? For me? Can I turn myself in?
We want Vanderlyn.
Old Dutch. I haven't seen him for months.
That's so. Because I heard guy fitting his description robbed a train belonging to Leviticus Cornwall up near Granite Pass.
Oh, ain't that a little old-fashioned nowadays?
Apparently not. Listen. This is my offer, Mr. Morgan. Bring in Vanderlyn, and you have my word you won't swing.
Oh, I ain't gonna swing anyways, Agent.
Milton.
You see, I haven't done anything wrong, aside from not playing the games to your rules.
Spare me the philosophy lesson. I've already heard it from Mac Callender.
Mac Callender?
He was pretty shot up by the time I got to him. So really, it was more of a mercy killing. Slow, but merciful.
You enjoy being a rich man's toy, do you?
I enjoy society, flaws and all. You people venerate savagery, and you will die. Savagely, all of you.
Oh, we're all gonna die, Agent.
Some of us sooner than others. Good day, Mr. Morgan.
Goodbye.
Enjoy your fishing, kid. While you still can.
Who are they?
No one to worry about. No one at all. Come on, let's pick up your things and get home. It's getting late, Jack. Your mother would be worried. Let's head back.
Duchess.
Because those are disagreeable men, and I don't want them to hurt him.
What did they mean about Mac? Is he in jail?
No, I don't think so. I hope he's just fine where he is. Like I said, don't worry about them. World is full of disagreeable men. That's why you got all of us to protect you from folk like them. Now, how about that necklace you made? You still got it, right?
Yeah, I got it.
Good. Did you like fishing?
It was okay, I think. It's a lot of waiting around.
It is.
Boys getting on.
Great. We caught a fish, and I made you this necklace.
Ain't that pretty? Ain't I the luckiest? Did you thank Uncle Arthur?
No need. We had a good time.
What's wrong?
Nothing. Just met some folk. I better go speak with Dutch.
Okay.
Hey, you did real fine, kid.
Thanks.
We got a problem.
What?
I just met some guys out near the river. A fella named, Milton, and, I don't remember the other fella's name. Ross. Milton and Ross.
And
they are employees of the Pinkerton Detective Agency. And they know about the train, and they know we're here.
Were you followed back here?
No. They know we're near here. And they want you, Dutch. They offered me my freedom in exchange, they did.
Why didn't you take it?
Very funny. Well, what do we do now?
I say we do nothing. Just yet. They're just trying to scare us into doing something stupid. We have turned a corner. We survived them mountains. We just need to stay calm.
Morning, Arthur.
Don't you have any warmer clothes than that?
Hello. You might be the youngest, but some of the others could learn a thing or two from you.
Appreciate you saying that.
Here, I picked up this. I heard you talking about losing the one your pa gave you.
Well, that is mighty kind. Thank you, Arthur.
Don't mention it.
It's the reason we're living. It's the only thing that makes me happy.
So, the only thing that makes you happy is being in your head somewhere else?
Say, Morgan! Morgan, you got any hair pomade?
You never read?
You boys don't know your butt.
Fancy that.
But you can.
Yep. Whoa, easy. Yep. Easy, whoa. Slow up now. Yeah. Hey, boy. Easy there.
ya.
Hey, Arthur. Good to see you.
Why? You want rescuing again, dear?
No. I got a plan to make it up to you.
A plan like the Blackwater Ferry job, or like you going off scouting and ending up in jail?
Dutch said you was a big shadow cast by a tiny tree.
I don't even know what that means.
I thought you was a tough boy. Not one of those gentlemen trying to protect his riding clothes.
Well, I just know whenever things get real, you turn yellow, lose your head.
Yellow?
Sure seems that way.
So I guess you won't be riding with me to rob the banking coach comes about this time into Strawberry. I heard one of the O'Driscoll boys yapping about it while I was inside.
You and me? Do a robbery?
That's what I said, didn't I?
After you.
There's a spot up this way with a good view of the trail.
What are you doing anyway, camping out here like some crazy hermit?
Can't exactly stay in town now, can I? Like I told you, I ain't going back to Dutch without a peace offering.
So what's the deal with this coach?
What do you mean? Comes through about this time every day, like I said, the end.
I mean, how many men? Guns. Riders.
Nothing serious. It'll be fine.
I heard the bank's been hiring every trigger man they can get of late. The meaner, the better.
You worry too much.
Forgive me if I ain't wholly faithful in something an O'Driscoll told you when you was half drunk in a jail cell.
He kept yapping about it, saying how they've been hitting it on the regular. That's a good lead in my book.
Damn, O'Driscolls are everywhere now.
Bastards got a hold of most of Big Valley. Heard they took over some big ranch north of here.
How the hell you and Lenny end up down here, anyway?
Oh, you know how it is? Few loose ends. Drink here, drink there.
What loose ends?
Nothing that needs to concern you. I always pay my share.
It concerns me when you put us in danger and we don't realize till it's too late. Like that move you pulled in Strawberry, making me kill half the town just for your precious guns.
Precious they are. You need to roll a little looser, Morgan.
Looser? I seen you come full undone more than once now, and you only been running with us a few months.
Are we gonna rob this coach or bicker about it? What's done is done.
Guess we're robbing it.
Then let's do it.
Thank you.
This is the spot. Hold up on this ridge.
Hold!
They should be here in a little bit. Hold tight.
Which way will they be coming in?
Should be from over there. We need to hit them fast before they get into town.
Just don't lose your head this time.
Of course, tough guy. They should be here any minute. Look, there they are. Right on time. Get covered up. Come on! Ride! Here! Keep your face covered now. It's just you and me, sweetheart. I'll give it to them. Put up half a fight, at least. Yeah! Baylock! Come on, boy! Here. Fine new rifle, too. Here you go, Arthur. From me to you. That's more your style than mine. What did I tell you? Like licking butter off a knife.
Something like that. You don't want to just break it open here, be done with it?
Could be more than we can carry. And there might be a second crew of riders tailing.
All right, then.
Not to mention, we ride back in with a big take. New wagon to boot? Dutch can't say we ain't pulling our weight no more, can he?
I ain't sure I trust this new act of yours one bit.
Listen, I know we got off on the wrong foot, but I got no beef with you. I reckon we're a lot alike, you and me.
Now, hold up there.
Dutch knows I'm a feller that gets things done, same as you.
Gets things done? You'd be wearing a California collar now if I hadn't broken you out of jail.
Shit! Now we're being robbed! Get across the river! What the hell?